Hi everyone, welcome to Be Smart Together. I am the wanted KT. Please click subscribe and turn on the notification to avoid missing valuable videos. Also, feel free to drop a comment or throw me any Excel challenges, and I will show you the best way to deal with them in future videos. There is uncertainty at work, and we get inconsistent data structure. As a result, we spend a lot of time cleaning the data rather than doing the actual work. Today I will show you how to build a smart model to combine multiple files from different file paths, promote headers row and remove empty columns. The first section focuses on transformation and creating a custom function. Firstly, let us import a workbook. I am importing the most unstructured file for today's lesson. Here are the headers we want to promote to the column header row, but we have blank rows and columns. Remember, every workbook are inconsistent structure. So, we need to know AI to achieve it. I am kidding. Please keep your eyes open. The first transformation step is to add an index column. The headers are at row 16, and the index column will give the number 15. Let me show you how we use the number 15 in a second. We need to add a custom column and name it create record. Type record.toList, open parenthesis, underscore and close parenthesis. Then click OK to continue. Click on the added column, row 16. You will see the bottom information pane showing the list. Let's lift up the information pane to see the full list. We want to add another layer to the existing formula. Type list.ContainsAny, open parenthesis and adds a close parenthesis at the end. The newly added formula searches through each row for the keyword unit cost and returns either true or false. Click OK to continue. Only row 16 returns true, which is what we want. Now filter for true. Add this code, and you will get the number of rows to skip to get the headers before we promote them to the headers row. We have another two formulas to add to the existing one. We need to go back to the added index step and copy the highlighted reference code before we write to add the two formulas. Now, go back to the last step and add table.skip, open parenthesis, paste the copied code and add a close parenthesis at the end of the formula. This formula will dynamically skip rows and bring the headers to row 1. Add table.PromoteHeaders, open parenthesis and add a close parenthesis at the end of the formula. The last transformation step is to remove empty columns. The formula can be a bit complex and required to combine them together to have it works. Click on the FX to create a custom step. Please replace the default reference code with this formula. Let's delve into a bit about the formula. The logic is we want to select all other columns except these two empty columns. We use this formula to get data from each of the columns from the previous step. We then applied this formula, searching through each row that is not equal to null and returning a list of columns that is not empty. We then use this formula to get the complete column name list and use this formula to select only the column names that appear on the list from the matches formula. Now we have the list of column names that we want, and we can use this formula to select only the columns on the list. Hit enter, and the empty columns are now removed. Let us rename the steps. The last step is to turn this query into a function. Go to the advanced editor. Enter to insert a row before let and enter this code. Then, we need to replace the current folder path, file name and worksheet name with the added code. Click done, then rename the query to FX transformation. We just created a custom function. Let us create a parameter input table then I will show you how to apply the function. Let's create a parameter input table with three columns, folder path, file name and worksheet. Then, import the table into Power Query. Now we can apply the custom function. Now we can apply the custom function. Enter the FX transformation formula as per the callout box. Click OK to continue. Let's click on each table and check out the result from the preview pane. Awesome. The result looks great. We want to combine those files now. Right-click on the custom column header and select drill down. All we need to do is to add the table.combine formula. Tada! All the files are now combined perfectly. There is a downside with the text.combine formula. You lost the file name. I want to show how to resolve it. Go back to the added custom step and add another custom column. What we want to do is to add a file name to each of the tables. Click OK to continue. Click on the first table to check the result. The file name is now added to the tables. Recap, we wrote the table.AddColumn is to add a column in each of the tables. Now go to the custom step, and we need to update the formula from custom to custom.1. Then, take a quick check of the result. All good. We can load it to Excel now. Thank you for watching, and I hope you find this video helpful. Please don't forget to click like if you like the video.